These are mere scratches. Those wounds of yours need to be treated. These are mere scratches. These are mere scratches.
Life. I don't want to lose it. My precious life. I don't want to lose it.
Before I realized it, Ilisebra had walked off. The monster was near death. Magusa made his usual sacrifice of the beast. Circumstances be damned.
This was the only means of ensuring they were reunited.
The monster's carcass turned to mush, and we absorbed it. Straight into our right arms, where the soul of her husband already resided, where they will meet again, if only as kindred souls. Was this deed a selfish act? Perhaps. But there is little the survivors of the dead can do to atone. Our actions weigh heavily upon us. I have felt an onus ever since the moment I sacrificed Sortiara. If that too was an act of selfishness. I wonder why I can never seem to leave it behind. What can be done so that these lost souls may rest in peace? It is we, the living, who are left to brood on such matters. I feel certain that Illisibra will cause us further difficulty. Magusa was disgusted by her designs to take us with her in death.
We cannot afford to indulge that old crone.
Old crone? Did you say old crone?
Yes, for is she not just that?
Was it only me? Did Illisibra only resemble Sortiara through my eyes? Why did she take the face of Sortiara? Before I realized it, Illisibra had walked.
This was the only.
The monster's car. If. Was this deed. But. If I. I feel certain.
We. Yes.
Was it only me? Did Illisibra only resemble Sortiara through my eyes? Why did she take the face of Sortiara? Perhaps I am already insane, and am just the last to know. 6 days until the end of the world.
I'm impressed. Very few have managed to read this far. You may stand a good chance after all. Hello. Have you checked for droplets recently?
Bodies and all manner of innards strewn about. It was all my doing. A rampage, total loss of control. My right arm was still fresh. Warm, eviscerated entrails. I had little room for denial. The clock on my humanity is winding down. I stood in the ruins with the dank stench of death, reflecting upon the gravity of my sins.
It seems all the residents have been consigned to oblivion.
Thank you.
Then an image of my mother flashed into my mind. Why now? This was not usual. There must be some reason that I would remember her at this moment. To find an answer, I had to untangle a complex web formed by the strings of fate. Only later would I realize that it was all fated to happen. From the moment I set foot in that town, I knew that it was the place my mother once lived. For it perfectly matched a story I heard when I was very young. My mother was driven out over some insignificant happenings.
A fine spree of death indeed.
Magusa spoke with dead calm.
Only your victims were not alive in the first place.
5 days until the end of the world.
The journal begins to touch somehow upon the author's mother. Why would she suddenly come up now? Read on to discover the most peculiar answer. Hello. Have you checked for droplets recently?
When we came upon my mother's town, its inhabitants had perished long before. A story my mother told me long ago explained this. The tale matched what she had said. The townspeople were projections. I had massacred apparitions. Eerie phantoms, which were the work of one man. The man loved his fair town. Loved it too much, one might say. When disease struck the town, the man refused to believe it. His desires led him to stray from the path of good. With ghastly newfound powers, he restored the good old days. We came for him and started with the destruction of his phantom puppets. We knew that slaughtering his dolls would tease him out.
It seems we've lured out the monster, just as we planned. He's a mere scratch. He's a mere scratch.